Hello friends, welcome to my channel. So in this lecture, I am going to explain about the reagent chemistry. So we are in reagent chemistry right now, right? So in this last lecture, we had a discussions with DMSO reagent, sulfur based reagents. So in this previous lecture, I had a discussion about Kahn-Brom oxidations as well as Barton modified reactions, right? So now again today, I am going to discuss about the Pfitzer-Moffat oxidations as well as parik-doering reactions. These are also sulfur based reagents. Why this much of these are all sulfur based reactions? Because in previous Kahn-Brom oxidations as well as Barton modified reactions, there is some drawbacks on those reactions, like it's need more temperature or less yield. So everything is a cause of those reactions. So that's the reason again they are modified. So you know here it Pfitzer-Moffat oxidations, it is discovered in 1963. So if we see here reagents, what is the reagents we are using here? DCC and as well as DMSO and protons, whatever you know, it will give the protons. So we are taking those compounds. It is also same oxidizing agents. What are the oxidizing? It will take place here, primary alcohols to aldehydes, and as well as secondary alcohols, it is converted into ketones. Everything in every DMSO, there are only for oxidizing of this alcohols, primary alcohols to aldehydes, secondary alcohols to ketones. If it is tertiary containing alcohols, it does not take place any oxidations on those tertiary alcohols. So here I give some examples to you. If you see that these examples, after that we will go for the mechanism. First you see, so here we have examples, right? So which alcohol it is containing? So it is a primary containing, right? Primary containing alcohols is converted into aldehydes. So simply you should write here it is a aldehyde. So in this question you can see here we have esters. So here we have another group. So here you can see alcohols, primary alcohols, right? So this primary, you will write everything is same, but the thing is here you can write aldehyde. That's it. These are all very simple questions. If you understand what is that reagent exactly playing a role, what is that is playing a role, so everything you should write same here. One you can ester group, and as well as you can see here we have alcohols. Which alcohols it is? Secondary alcohols, am I right? So secondary alcohols is converted into ketones. Tertiary, so here we have secondary alcohols to ketones, right? This is for our product. And if you see the mechanism, what is that happening in this mechanism? We'll go that mechanism. Yeah, what is that exactly happening here? So here I am going to take the, but what are the reagents we are using? First to DCC. So DCC structures would be like this. N double bond C, double bond N. Here we have cyclic. And it is treated with first DMSO. We should write DMSO like this, right? Because yesterday class only I had a discussion about this. This nucleophile is attacked on this carbonyl center and this bond is migrated here. You will get negative charge. In this negative charge, we have taking the H3PO4 protons. It will give the protons where it is required. So if this nitrogen is attacked on those protons, then we can get N, C, here you have a S, positive charge, and hydrogen, here again cyclic member ring, right? You can see here, what happened? Again, we are going to take the alcohols R dash OH. So if you see this lone pair of electrons is attack and this sulfur and this bond will group here, then we can get R dash and O, and it is going to attack sulfur group. So you will get this kind of things, right? So here you have a same hydrogen. Again, your byproduct will get DCU urea type. And next, it is treated with a base. Base, what will do the base? Base, obviously, it will take the protons, right? So here it is taking the protons. You will get negative charge. We have a hydrogen here. This negative charge is take the proton here, and this bond is migrated here, and this bond is migrated towards the here. So we'll get finally ketones, right, as well as DMS, dimethyl sulfide. This is the byproduct. This is for what? Our ketones. So this is one type of mechanism of this Pfitzer-Moffat reaction. As well as one more your reaction you can see here. This reaction is parik-doering reaction. Parik-doering reaction also one type of DMSO containing oxidizing agent. If you see, it is discovered in 1967, because that just now we had a discussion about the Pfitzer-Moffat reaction, that is discovered in 1963. It is in 1967 because those reactions having some drawbacks. Again, this reactions modified. So here they are taking reagents is SO3, pyridine, DMSO and base, right? It is also using same primary alcohols to aldehydes, secondary alcohols to ketones, right? It is also DMSO containing reactions, sulfur based reactions. If you see here, we have a primary alcohols. Simply you can say where you have a primary alcohol, then you can keep aldehydes. And here you can see, here you have a secondary alcohols. Simply you can keep there itself ketones, and it is also same because here you have a tertiary alcohol. This is the tertiary alcohols. Tertiary alcohols will not take place the reaction, only primary and secondary alcohols. And if you see the mechanism, so that we can understand what is that exactly happening in this reaction. So what are the reagents we are going to take on here in the sense? So here we have a pyridine, right? Pyridine is treated with a SO3. So if you see here carefully, this lone pair of electrons is migrated toward the sulfur, and this bond is migrated here. So here you can get double bond O minus. Here you will get positive charge because nitrogen containing four bonds. So again, workup. I said workup in the sense where it is protons required, it will give the protons, it will take the protons, oxygen take the protons. Here you will get C double bond OH, positive charge. So it is treated with a DMSO. This is DMSO. This lone pair of electrons is migrated toward the sulfur, and this pyridine will leave again. So it is activating. That's it. So here we'll see what happens. Here S, here positive charge, and here O, it is attack on this OH, right? So again it is treated with a, you can take alcohols here, one type of ketones. So this lone pair of electrons is migrated here and this bond will leave, right? So we'll get R dash O, because here we have a hydrogen, right? If we'll keep here hydrogen, in the sense we'll get positive charge. It is highly unstable because of oxygen containing only two bonds. So after that hydrogens will leave. So I'll write the direct step here. So it is treated with sulfur, CH2 H CH3, here positive charge. So again it is treated with a base. What will do the base? It will take the protons. Here you will get negative charge. Here we have a hydrogen. This hydrogen will take place and this bond will migrate here and this DMS will leave. So finally you will get the products R dash plus DMS ketone. This is for what? DMSO oxidizing agent. Right? So this is for what? Sulfur based oxidizing agents. So if you see Corekim oxidation and Swan oxidation is also sulfur based reagent. So we'll discuss on those reactions in a next class. Thanks for watching this video.